get some?
Mm-hmm. We have. I just got done last week. We have 5 more weeks of this and then 8 months of pizza.
Sweet low and skin low.
Get her done,
Bobby. Get her done, Bobby.
See you next year.
Welcome once again to the Federal States and Soldier Field. Finale of the four-game weekend series between the Eagles of North Carolina Central University and your Delaware State University Hornets. At this time, we ask you to direct your attention to the flagpole in center field for the playing of our national anthem. Central, leading off the second baseman, number 18, Coco Figueroa. Batting second, the catcher, number 7, Chet Sykes. Hitting third, the designated hitter, number 24, Tristan Shen. Batting fourth, the left fielder, number 35, Luis Daniel. Hitting fifth, the right fielder, number 22, Jason Kudelka-Reagan. Batting sixth, the shortstop, number 17, Cameron Morgan. Hitting seventh, the third baseman, number 23, Morton Mayer. Batting 8th and playing first base, number 19, Justin Bowers. Hitting 9th and playing center field, number 1, Jake Fajardo. And pitching for the Eagles today, number 9, Ryan Miller. Here are the starters for Delaware State, leading off the second baseman, number 9, Miguel Romero. Batting 2nd, the shortstop, number 3, John Wenglars. Hitting 3rd, the left fielder, number 13, Trey Page. Batting
cleanup, the designated hitter, number 34,
Gary. Batting 5th, the playing first base, number 4, Drew Bolden. Hitting 6th, the third baseman, number 31, Jared Gillis. Batting 7th, the catcher, number 15, Robert Trujillo. Batting 8th, the playing right field, number 11, Trip Kimmel. Batting 9th, the center fielder, number 22, Mark Herron. And pitching for the Hornets today, number 6, C.J. Loper.
So, Corey Loper Jr., known as CJ, will pitch today as the Hornets try to win the series. They are up 2-1 after splitting yesterday's doubleheader. Loper is 1-2 in 6 appearances so far this season with an ERA of 8.66. In 17 and two-thirds innings of work, he surrendered 28 hits for 17 earned runs. He's walked 15, but has also struck out 15. He has given up 6 doubles and 3 home runs.
Leading off for NC Central, second baseman Coco Figueroa.
And the game is now underway. Coco Figueroa leading off for the North Carolina Central Eagles. I want to give credit to the cameraman for the beautiful shot of our flag as the anthem was playing. I also want to mention that I am your broadcaster, Derek Slayton, and I'm also working the camera today. I'm also the cameraman, so I just gave myself some praise. And thank you for tuning in to DESU-TV live stream. Simple ground ball to Miguel Rivera for the first out of the game.
Up next for the Eagles, catcher Chet Sykes.
Chet Sykes, who had a home run yesterday, is up to bat. Pitches a ball. Second one is fouled out of play. Counts 1-1. Lopa, one of the better pitchers in this bullpen, or rotation rather. But has dealt with injuries throughout his career here. Was having a very good year last season before the coronavirus lockdown. He's trying to return to that form. Both dugouts really active today. The Eagles obviously want to tie the series 2-2 before they head home. The Hornets want to take that 3-1 series win. Good pitch there by Loper. Second and then throws to first for the double play, and that will be the end of the top of the first inning. The Hornets only surrendering one walk, but still getting three outs, three up and three down after that double play.
Strikeouts.
last season before the coronavirus lockdown, he was leading the league. He had 36 strikeouts and just 23 and one-third innings of work. We talk a lot about Austin Meadows being one of the better pitchers in the league, or maybe the best. But his teammate, Ryan Miller, is just as impressive. Once again, it's just a
really short
sophomore.
Leading off to the second baseman, Miguel Rivera.
Miguel Rivera.
Miguel Rivera leading off, and he's just as impressive as a player. Rivera batting 341. And 91 at bats. He has 31 hits. Driving in 11. He has 27 runs as well. And Rivera caught looking. So Miller showing why he's one of the best in the act early on, best strikeout.
Batting for the Hawks, stop with John Wendler.
Wendler still batting over 400. His average is at 413. Good plays there by first baseman Justin Bowers, picking up the ground ball and tagging first base for out number two.
Now batting for the Hornets,
Trey Page, who in this game two of the doubleheader had two hits, driving in one run. And a liner right to Bowers, who makes a terrific catch for out number three. We talking just to get a beverage.
Pair of boots and a sack of clothes.
Just for a storyline here. In other words, state baseball team has secured at least a tie in its four-game MEAC weekend series against North Carolina Central after a 3-2 win in game two of the doubleheader yesterday. North Carolina Central took game one of the Twin Hill 9-3. But in the second game, Jordan Hathaway earned a win for the Hornets. After tossing five and two thirds innings, allowing just three hits and striking out three. The Hornets managed just three hits in the ninth half. Two by Trey Page, who we just mentioned earlier in his last game. Delaware State opened the game, scoring with a run in the bottom of the first inning. John Wendler drew a one out run and later crossed the plate with the first run of the game on a sack fly by Chris Glover. After the Eagles tied the game with a run in the second, the Hornets regained the lead in the bottom of the third when Page doubled, one out, and later scored on a wild pitch. Page singled in Miguel Rivera in the fifth to give the Hornets a 3-1 lead. North Carolina Central scored a run in the top of the seventh and had runners on second and third with two outs. But the Hornets' Chandler Fitzgerald was able to get out of the jam on a fly ball with two outs that center fielder Mark Hanna handled for the last out of the game and gave that Hornets team a split in yesterday's doubleheader.
Yeah.
Now at the plate is Luis De Leon. Gillis makes a nice play on that ground ball.
Now batting for the Eagles, right fielder Jacob Rady.
Been impressed by pretty much all the at bats that I've seen from Jacob Rady so far in this series. Had three hits in two games yesterday. Had a home run in the first game of a doubleheader. Counts 1-1 with one out in the top of the second. Score is still 0-0. Count is now 2-1.
All right, finish here, CJ.
Good breaking ball to the outside of the left plate, or just inside of the left plate. For strike two, counts 2-2. That one off target. Now we have a full count 3-2 against Raven, who's has gotten a lot of full counts in all of his at-bats. It seems like he's been really patient. He has the ability to foul off some good pitches to keep his at-bat going. But right there, that's when it is. It's like when I talk about what a player does, they do the exact opposite. Was unable to get any contact on that one and goes down swinging for out number two.
Now batting for the Eagles, shortstop Cameron Norwood.
Who had an over yesterday, was over 7 in two games. And he went down out to Drew Bolden. Very much a team player. He's just looking to help his team out in any way. You can tell by throwing those two walks, trying to hack at one.
The second to Delaware State designated hitter, Cole Garrett. Batting for the Hornets, first baseman, Crew Bolden,
who pitched in the first game of the doubleheader yesterday and then played first base in the second game. Very versatile player. You love to have players you can move all around your lineup. Mentioned that Bolden had a sack fly in game two of the doubleheader.
Stay back at the feet. Stay back at the feet.
Just made a solid play in the top half of the inning, handling a ground ball and tagging the first base for out number three. He's down 0-2 in the count. And foul off that one.
Hey, stay back at the feet here.
And as we gave praise to Jacob Raby for how he's always forcing 3-2 counts, you can make the case for pretty much everybody in this Hornets lineup. Forces pitchers to throw a lot. And Drew Bolden will make it to first base on a fielder's choice. Cole Gehry out at second.
Thank you.
Got that in for the Hornets. Third baseman Jared Gillis.
Gillis started to string together some good at bats. This is his 12th game of the season. It is a good portion of the first half of the year. Starting to return to form as of late. And we already know about his defensive prowess. In years past, he's been an all-MEAC third baseman. Miller making sure Bolden doesn't get too good of a leadoff. Obviously, if you're the Eagles, you would love a double play there, so he's going to try to make sure that stays intact. Gillis fouls off that pitch. Counts 1-1. And that one will roll foul. Now the count's 1-2. A pretty solid battle here between two all-MEAC performers. Another foul. Count still 1-2 with one out in the bottom of the second inning. Cole Gehry had a hit to start the inning. And then Drew Bolden made it to first on a fielder's choice. He remains there as of now. Gillis will make it to first on a fielder's choice as well. And grounds it to the second baseman. Or sorry, the shortstop. He throws it to second base. A good hard run by Bolden made it hard for a double play to happen. Pick a job at least racing down that first base line as well to keep the double play from happening, preserving the inning as for now. Robert Trujillo is at bat, batting just under 300. Brian Miller checking first base. Strike one.
All right, Rob, here we go, kid.
Two outs, bottom of the second. Real fouls off that pitch. Counts 1-2, 2 outs. As of late, we joked with him that he better get a hit, or you'll be listening to Barney again. He said that he will get us a hit today, so we're definitely going to hold him to his word. Remember, a very consistent hitter, just going through a little bit of a rough patch. Fouls that one back. But it's someone that you just have to keep in the lineup because. One, he has been a consistent hitter throughout his career and also a terrific right fielder as well. Good eye there by Kimmel. Counts 1-2. That one is outside for ball two. Counts 2-2-2. Catcher setting up slightly outside here. Kimmel, can he beat out the throw? No, he cannot. He'll ground out to the first baseman. Throws it back to Miller, who tags the base. Good play there by Bowers and Miller. So that's out number 3.
Baby, I Nosotros quien paga, si no, no te amo, ve. Yo soy el dueño de vulgar y cuando te lo quito, después te lo pari. Las copas de vino, las libras de mari. Estás bien suelta, yo de safari. Tú me ves el culo fenomenal, pa' yo devorarte como animal. Si no estás venido, yo te voy a esperar. En mi camino voy a celebrar. Baby, a ti no me pongo, y siempre te lo pongo. Y si tú me tiras, si por mí te lo pongo, de septiembre hasta agosto, a mis 5 años lo que digan tu amiga, ya yo me enteré, se nota cuando me vas, ahí donde no llego, sabes que yo te llevaré, dime qué quieres beber, es que tú eres mi bebé, y de nosotros quién va a hablar, si no, no te vamos a ver, sí, mami me tienes buqueado, sí. Si fuera la Uru me tuviese parqueado, dando vueltas por el condado contigo, siempre arrebatado. Tú no eres mi señora, pero toma 5,000, gastalo en Sephora. Y puto, ya no compré en Pandora.
leading off the third for North Carolina Central. Third baseman, Court Mayer.
Court Mayer now batting for the Eagles. First pitch is a strike. Mayer went 0 for 8. The doubleheader. Just 1 of 13 in the series. He came into the weekend batting just under 300. He was one of the best hitters, if not the best hitter in the league last season. Pitch inside for ball 2. And the sun just disappeared out of nowhere. Now it's a little bit darker. Count 2-1. And there's Chuck for count number 2, showing you his range and why he's just such a valuable member to the team. There.
Hey, compete, boy. Come on.
Showing him some love. Now Bowers up to bat. Batting under 200, but has been solid in this series.
Now batting for Central, first baseman Justin Bowers.
He's batting 3 for 6 in this series. Also laid down a really terrific squeeze bunt in a doubleheader yesterday that brought home a run. Counts 1-2 for him.
This is it, see?
And that one just outside for ball 2. Let's see if Loper tries to challenge him with the fastball. Counts 2-2. Bowers has been hot here in this series, though. And that one, maybe it's had been hot. That was yesterday, that pitch was caught striking. Umpire yesterday was giving the high pitches credit to his strikes. Not that time. And Loper walks in. He knows he missed his spot on that one. You can see the reaction on his face. He's not at all happy with himself. Even though Bowers is batting 3 for 6 in the series, he's not a player you want to walk. One, because he's not a particularly great batter throughout the season, but also because he's pretty quick when he does reach base. And now you have to worry about a threat of stealing, if that is what he decides to try to do.
There you go, CJ!
First pitch is a strike.
Keep working, CJ! Keep working!
Fans here not at all pleased with that one being called a ball. It counts 1-1 with one out. Nick Fajardo batting. Fouls that one off.
Come on, CJ!
Fajardo, 2 of 8 in the series. Had both of his hits in the first game of the series. Went 0 for 4 in a doubleheader yesterday. Count is still 1-2.
Right here, CJ. Finish right here.
Beautiful pitch there from strike number 3 for CJ Roper. He's starting to look like his old self here.
That's what it was, a strike.
Go, 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 ball. Bowers still second. And as we were talking about, that's something that he has the ability to do. 6'5", but with his slight frame, he's a lot faster than what you expect for most first basemen. But he's also a versatile defender. He plays in the outfield as well for the Eagles. Now he's in scoring position. As the Eagles are back to the top of their lineup with Coco Figueredo at the plate. Wilbur takes a look back at second base to try to make sure that Bowers doesn't get a good leadoff here. But Bowers is doing just that. Ground ball to Gillis. Can he make the play? No, he cannot. And Bowers is safe at third as well. So runners on the corner. Terrific diving effort by Gillis, but
we got two, all right.
Couldn't see if Bolden bobbled the catch, which is why it wasn't an out, or if the runner just beat Gillis' throw to the bag. Either way, runners on the corners with two outs.
Now batting for the Eagles catcher, Chet Sykes.
Both a dangerous hitter in Sykes. At bat. Sykes is one of six in the series. That one hit was a home run. Swing and miss for the first strike.
Let's go,
baby. Another swing and miss. Jamil couldn't handle the pitch afterwards. And Figueredo advances to second. So now runners on second and third. Still two outs. Count is 0-2. Pretty big moment here in the top of the third inning. Right now the score is tied at zero. Let's see if Loper can get out of the jam here. Loper on that last throw really gave everything he could, and so did Kimmel as he tried to dive and catch that foul ball, unable to make the play. So the count is still 0-2 with two outs. Loper versus Sykes in a pretty critical moment here in the top of the third inning. And that one finds a gap in between third and the shortstop. One runner will go home. Two runners will go home. So, two-run RBI single for Chet Sykes. He wins that battle against C.J. Loper. And now the score is 2-0 at the top of the third inning. Runner on first. CJ Loper looks a little frustrated. Wanted to get out of that inning without giving up a run, obviously. Feels like he could have done that.
I'm off the moose, smelling like money and I'm looking like sick. I'm outside for real with the slabs and the to the right way, then there's some serious fraud. There's no pants, I feel them on the rest. And I'm all cap, but it's all facts. No, I don't relax and I don't laugh. Demons that follow me deep in the dark. Just got problems with being a boss. We ain't been hard, but we hear all the talk. Hit them with hollows and clean them with salt. Salt in the wound and my heart in the cooler. Frozen like I gave my heart to my chula. Told them to make a new piece out of this. Ever since I just can't get no problem.
Yeah. Baby, had a bust down on the hippie. Yeah. Baby, and all the thousand ladies. Yeah.
I got fans in Rosaria. I got fans in Rosaria. I
might pack numbers just before the video Lago. Knowing bass with the eighth, I'ma go psycho. Monkey Mac with a tap of this bitch cycle. Feel like we gotta go wherever I go. Go against the grain like a battle in the silo. Going out west like a mother five-o. LeBron in the finals, mother five-o. The better under 5-4, hell the final. Got me packed like I just fit this. Like I'm not an arsonist. Not a, that you wanna argue with. Cause then you fool with the people like cars and pitches.
Delaware State has a total pinfall of 3,979. After 20 games, Aretha Field in a big competition.
We lost the third for DSU center fielder Mark Ellison.
Mark Perry up to bat for the first time. First pitch is a ball. Second pitch is a strike and count is 1-1. That one grounded to first for out number one in the bottom of the third inning. Back to the top of the lineup. Down with that.
Back to the top of the order for the Hornets, now batting second baseman Miguel Rivera.
And the Hornets, they know that Ryan Miller is one of the best in the MEAC. Once again, only has an ERA of 2.25, which is probably the reason why CJ Roper was more frustrated than you would normally see after giving up two runs. They know how hard it would be to score on Miller here. As you can see, a wicked breaking ball. Miguel Rivera way out in front for strike number two. He was caught looking in the first inning, striking out. And he gets caught looking in the third inning, striking out. Rivera thinks that the strike zone is a little bit inconsistent. They're like, they are getting that outside of the plate. Oh, that's a strike. When they're on your knees. And it has some words for the umpire. That's where the umpire is right now. Also, having a little bit of a discussion. It's not really too heated or anything. But so we just got the explanation that Rivera is getting a warning for arguing balls and strikes.
Now batting for the Hornets shortstop, John Wegler.
Probably wasn't much as the argument itself, but what Rivera said at the end of that argument that led to the warning. Count is 0-1 in the bottom of the third. and it's been a theme all series long. Neither team really have much care, much like for the strike zone that the umps have been giving. Both teams have been arguing the strike zone all series long. But that's to be expected. You're going up against your rivals here. But everything will be a little bit more tense. And sometimes the umpires have to deal with that as well. And Rivera is able to get that through third. So I know Rivera, that was John Wedlaw's, able to squeeze that one past the third baseman. Morgan, shortstop, couldn't make the throw.
Now batting from the Hornets and left fielder Trey Page.
Trey Page. Up to bat. Rounds out to Bowers, who is not 6'5", you know, that one's going over his head, but that is some of the perks of having a 6'5 athletic player.
I want a long life, a legendary one. I want a quick death and an easy one. I want a pretty girl and an honest one. I want this drink and another one. And I'm troublesome. I'm a pop star, but it ain't bubble gun. You would probably think my manager is Scooter Braun. But my manager was 20 and Budokan. Hey, look, Ariana, Selena, my visa. It can take as many charges as it needs to, my girl. Platinum just like all of my releases, my girl. Come for me, I tear them all to pieces, my girl. I'ma show you sexy what relief is, my girl. Please don't take your this guy that had you peeking. And I'm not driving nothing that I gotta stick your keys in. Wonder how I got this way, I swear I got the... Calling my phone like I'm locked up, non-stop. From the plane to the helicopter, yo. Cops pulling up like I'm giving drugs out, nah. I'm a pop star, not a doctor. Calling my phone like I'm locked up, non-stop. From the plane to the helicopter, yo.
Leading off the fourth for the Eagles. Left fielder Luis De Leon.
Luis De Leon, majoring in sports medicine with a concentration in kinesiology. His hobbies are enjoying watching television, and his favorite dish is baked macaroni and cheese, according to the North Carolina Central website. Prior to coming to North Carolina Central, he played his JUCO ball at Central Alabama Community College. Last year before the lockdown,
all right, CJ, here we go, kid.
He ranked 8th in NCAA Division I and topped the MEAC in runs batted in. He had 24 RBIs in just 17 games. He was batting .393 with a slugging percentage of .689. Once again, before the COVID pandemic. That ball finds a gap between Gillis and Rivera. I'm sorry, that's actually Gillis and Weglaws. Weglaws and Rivera switched last season.
Not bad at the Eagles, right fielder Jacob Raby.
Score is 2-0 in the top of the fourth. Volper surrendered both of those runs last inning. Giving up a single that brought two runs in with two outs to Chet Sykes. And this one might be a home run. It's going back, back, back. Oh my goodness, what a catch by Brooke Kimmel. We talked about his fielding prowess. Another example of that. Probably save the run with that catch. That one wasn't going to be a home run, but it was like a totally hit the fence.
All right, Sixer, here we go. Roll your ground ball here, kid.
Loper surrendering some good hits here, though. Has to be a little concerning for the Hornets. That one is a bit high.
Hey, Tom, let's fucking go, Tom. Hey, let's go.
You're terrible. You are controlling the game.
Believing that was a strike. Talking to the umpire, telling him to let's go, let's make some better calls, is what Landon was arguing. Foul ball. One and one with one out. What he planned is that he is not afraid of an ejection if it leads to a better strike zone for his pitcher. The dugout was already charged with one warning. And if Landon continues to argue balls and strikes, he will have to be ejected. That's the spot. That inside spot has been a ball each time, and everyone is getting a bit frustrated. The umpire is not calling that a strike. Luckily, nobody got hit. Everybody kind of ducked for cover. Even I, you can see the camera shift to the left. I wasn't trying to make a play on the ball at all. That is not my ability. I talk, I don't play. Got him swinging and missing for strike number three.
You're
you are athlete number one, Rob. Oh, Michael.
Way to be
CJ.
Norgren.
Not bad for NCC. He goes to the fourth moment.
Show some heart. Come on.
Hey,
come
on. Go, CJ.
Hey, win his fight, big six. Win his fight, big kid.
Later now batting. Junior from Charlotte, North Carolina.
Sumo!
5'11", third baseman. One and one.
Come on, we got a locate,
Great throw there by Rivera. It was a great play, but Maynard able to beat out the throw. Still just two outs. Runners on first and second. Trujillo will talk to Loper. Are down 2-0, top of the fourth inning. Two outs. Runners on first and second. Another ball. With a swing and a miss. The last time Bowers was at the plate, he was walking.
Hey, Justin, I can see your legs, bro.
That's a nasty pitch there by Loper. Strike number two. The count is 2-2 with two outs. Another big moment.
Good eye, Justin. Give me one more strike there, buddy.
Brian Miller on the other side. He's important. He just cannot surrender too many runs. And that one ruled foul. That would have probably brought two home. As it remains, runners are back on first and second. Another foul ball. Let's have a better jump on that one. Count still 2-2 with two outs.
All right, Sixer, here we go.
And that would look like a strike, but instead it will be ball three. Strike's always been tight here.
Come on, six, come on, six.
To start the game.
There you go!
Hard swinging. And Susan Roper is fired up past the door.
To me to a beast. Invisible says diamonds are in my piece. But me for a sure, I need 80 at least. I'm on the smoking, no keeping the peace. Give me a razor when I'm on the east. Open them up just like a surgery. Everything burning around me, all lit. Show a little attitude, swap out the I spent 250, don't know where it went. My hood on my back, I gotta represent. Toronto, you need to be dug out of pole. I'm that boy up, he got shot in the cold. 30 rounds in the clip, let it unload. I could chop it right out of hold. Took 20 clips on the first big game. I picked another rap, chase little baby. Every other rap got diamonds in the face. Pulling out past, take a taste, little baby. Pulling out, pick a rap, walking out of chase. If I drop that beat, I'll be real clean. Trying to get thirsty, got water like a leak. My brother got locked, another father got pain. Cop by off-stuff, came by to see the green. Pull up, I make a quick stop, I shot one stop, I'm hop 7 days. Dealing, I see up and out of rain. Chopper get it, chopping like a blade. You ain't get no money, but you popping on your pay. Choosing, we can never be the same. No, I let flirt, no stress. Trust some friend, it'll work out, be that friend. She sweet, I'll move up, perk. I pull up, perk, and a birthday cake. I just tell like why I've been playing. Bitch, I'm crazy and great. There's no way, this be no way.
Leading off the fourth for Delaware State, designated hitter Cole Gary.
First pitch is a ball. One thing I've always been a fan of with Cole Gary is just his discipline at the plate. He has a really good eye. But we'll ground that one out to the second base. Easy play there for Figueredo.
Up next for the Hornets, first baseman Crew Bolden.
Hey Crew, start us off here, man. Hey Crew. Let's take.
First pitch is a strike for Crew Bolden. The Hornets haven't seriously threatened to score, despite having 3 hits so far in the game. They've had a couple of singles, but nobody's been able to advance past first base. Bolden strikes out. And Miller up to 3 strikeouts now. Last time these two guys met.
Now batting for the Hornets, third baseman Jarrett Gillis.
Miller was able to get the best of Gillis. Good breaking ball there from Miller. He's been very good at changing his pitches and his location. That one low and gets behind him. That's ball one.
Come on, Gil.
Swing and a miss for Gillis. That pitch was outside, and Gillis kind of chasing out of the strike zone there. That one inside for ball two. Count is 2-2. With 2 outs in the bottom of the 4th inning, the Hornets still trail 2-0.
Hey, Gil, let's go, baby. Good night. Hey, Gil. Hey,
Gil. Gillis fouls this one out of play. Count still 2-2, but just been some good battles between these guys so far in this game. That one is a ball 3. Full count here. And a swing and a miss. Ryan Miller, as you said, has been as advertised. Striking out Lewis.
They're going to turn back around.
Also struck out Drew Bowden. That's four strikeouts and four innings.
Spin it, block, spin it. One more time. Got the drop on your center side. Me and Turkey, you go back to back. Hanging out the window, back to back. Spin it, block, spin it. One more time. I know they got it. Throw that one more time. Cops, spin it one more time.
One more time.
Hit it one more time.
Let's get it. I'm a south side Englewood with a check. How the fuckers who would I say you ain't kill nobody yet? Who was holding up the promise? They was holding up a tech. While my amigo drink Corona, we was pouring up a tech. So don't ever front your movies.
Some softball moves. Well, you should always stay softball tuners. That fourth of Lynch card after winning two games. At the DSU Capitol on Saturday. The boys began the day with a 5-2 victory over the Philadelphia Eagles. They were close to the lead with 6-3 over the South Seahawks. DSU's Brianna McIntosh had a complete game. And Jonah Cunningham McIntosh allowed just one earned run while striking out six, totaling 43 in the season. The Hornets scored all their runs in the third inning. Nicolette Berenger singled to lead off the inning and scored the game's first run with a single by Jack Monahan. Cunningham followed up with a two-run triple to give the DSU a 3-0 lead. And we'll continue with the softball story after this at bat.
Leading off the fifth for Central, center fielder Nick Fajardo.
Nick Fajardo now batting. Fajardo with the single to right field. So quickly I'll talk about the rest of the softball game. In the second game, Michaela Nelson turned in a strong performance. While Baker was 3-for-4 with a home run and 3 RBIs. Jay King also drove in 2 runs in victory against South Carolina State. Nelson allowed just 7 hits and 2 runs while striking out 3 without a walk to earn the complete game victory. The Hornets softball team is now 8-6 in the MEAC, and they will wrap up the MEAC roundup against North Carolina A&T, which started today at 10 a.m. Single.
Nice. Easy.
Back in third base. That brought in 2 runs in the top of the third inning. This time he grounds it to Red Laws and a quickie for the Hornets. Mentioned a lot about Brian Nelson and obviously deserves all of the credit and recognition, but C.J. Loper is having himself a good outing as well.
Baby, welcome to the party. Huh? I hit the boy up and then I go see him around. Baby, welcome to the party. What the hell? Baby, man. Come on. One night. Send a clip. Baby. Baby, I'm trying to slow your tongue. Cause you can get hit. Don't let that hit my system. I get you butt. Stay up again. Try to score a butt. listen again. Let me swim.
2 runs to 0. First pitch is a ball.
Got it. Good morning from right fielder Trip Kimmel.
I'd love to make some contact here, and for the Hornets to finally get a runner past first base. Job by Sykes, blocking the pitch, keeping Trujillo at first. Ball number 2, count is 2-0, no outs. Bottom of the 5th inning, it's a beautiful and sunny Sunday afternoon contest. We've had some gloomy weather here recently in Dover, Delaware, so it is a welcoming sight to have the sun back. Ball 3, Kimmel being very disciplined. He's not forcing anything back.
It's easy, Trip!
Let's see if he does decide to be aggressive or if he'll try to draw a walk.
All right,
Trip, here we go, 1-1.
It's the sweet
Trip,
it's
baseball, Trip. At first base, and Ryan Miller trying to keep him there.
Find a barrel, get a bag.
And ball 4. Kimmel will head to first base. Runners on first and second. This is the first time the Hornets have had 2 runners on base.
I think you're
All right,
Mark,
let's
go, kid.
Now batting for the Hornets, center fielder Mark Hill. Biggest thing for him is just not to get hit into that double play. Especially if you have your top of the order guys coming with Rivera on deck. Aaron looking like he's trying to squeeze down a bunt. That one is foul. Off of him. First strike number 1.
All right, 2-2, here we go.
Hey, Heron realizes it's a ball and aborts on the bunt. Brings the ball or bat back up to his shoulder for ball one.
You got it.
And that one is fouled off the bat again. So now, probably we'll expect Heron to swing here. Count is 1-2.
Come on. He's a slow pitcher, man.
And he may have grounded to a double play. Let's see if they can turn it to. They come up. And he's able to throw the first base pass. Right, runners on the course. Pretty good situation here for the Hornets. Runners on the corners and have Miguel Rivera. Up to that.
Now batting for the Hornets, second baseman Miguel Rivera.
Hey, Mig, let's go, baby, Mig. You did a good job.
Got it. Rivera up the middle. Let he be able to turn two. Central does turn two. And that is the end of the inning. The Hornets don't agree. Rivera thought he was able to beat the tag. He's a little frustrated, threw his helmet and disgust with the call. Kimmel having some words with the umpires. Not sure if he was just tossed. Landon having some words. And this has been boiling over throughout the entire weekend. Despite having won 2 out of 3 games so far, the Hornets haven't felt like the calls have been necessary. Aaron wants to speak, so Kimmel wisely directing him to the dugout. Motion's running high here.
I got a lot to live, and go for a dive. I ain't got time.
crowd getting upset with the strike zone as well. That was ruled ball one. That one threw the ball.
Hey, let's go, CJ.
We've seen some ejections. We've seen tempers flaring here on the Hornets side. But a sign of a good team is to be able to channel that.
Let's
go. Okay. Back to back strikes for Loper. He's been settled in after giving up those two runs in a third inning.
Yes, sir!
Shane has some worries of the umpire about the strike zone, and that's been a point of contention for both sides. And Roper, when the tensions are high, he becomes better. He's a fiery pitcher.
Yeah, only good player.
Very good competitor. And he shines in these type of moments and these type of atmospheres.
Hey, CJ,
pull it up, man. First pitch is a ball. One out in the top of the sixth inning. Loper starting to get into a groove here. Strike one out. Counts one and one. That one way inside. This is Bailey on second at bat. He had a hit off of Loper earlier in the game. Probably just outside the plate there. Not a bad spot for CJ Loper, though. Counts now 2-1 with one out. Nothing could do with that one, just fouled it off.
Come on, compete, boy.
Out and fouled out, or flied out, sorry. Counts one and one. That one's fouled out of play. Counts one and two.
You gotta be better with two strikes now. Come on. Hey, your pitch here, six.
Runner on first base. Louis going on after getting hit by a pitch. Oh. Got him swinging and missing.
That was a good try, Jacob. Next time, probably.
I don't know if it's the broadcast or this that I just possessed, but Jacob Lynn struggling today in the
game. Cameron Miller
has bowed out, has a fly out, and now it's struck out. 42nd out. Top of sixth inning for North Carolina Central Eagles. And you can just see Loper is feeling it.
Hey, Kim, you can rack out with a strike, bro. Rack out with a strike, bro.
Loper throwing some nasty stuff. Never even make a baseball player look like a golfer. You're throwing pretty well. Bailey on took off at the pitch. Heads back to first after it's fouled out.
Okay, you're pitch six.
Of the play.
Be smart here.
Cameron Norgren.
Way ahead, way ahead.
He struck out last time. He was up to bat. That one. Did he get hit? Looks like he got hit. And he had him 1-2, but let him off the hook there. Okay, just too far inside. Now you have runners on first and second. Hit. Last time Loper was in a situation, he was able to get out of it. Let's see if he can do so here without surrendering any runs. Once again, with Miller on the other side, scoring two runs to tie it up would be hard enough.
There you go.
Need more runs, and you're really looking at a very difficult situation for the Hornets. He has hit the last three, or three out of the last four. Not really a fan of that one, and made it on base after it. Have to make an attempt to get out of the way of the ball. Maynard kind of invited the contact there. Some more chatter coming from the dugout after that hit by pitch call. Assume head coaching responsibilities having some worries with Jeff Miller, really the rest. The umpire was having some worries with him about the dugout. Bases loaded, two outs. Loper will have to deliver some of his best pitches here. And that one, almost out of reach of the only Jacob finally gathering, and no runners advance. Bases are loaded once again. Bauer is not known as a good hitter, but he's been pretty good in this series. Has a chance to add a couple more runs to the Eagles' lead. This one is a fly ball, and CJ Roper is fired up. Newer runs to the dugout of the Eagles. Also, good play by Aaron to ensure a handle and getting the third out of the game. Or the third out of the game.
Then
they get runs off of Ryan Miller. That was the storyline from the game. 5-0, 2-5. One of the best pitchers in the NBA. North Carolina Central has a host of great pitchers in their rotation. Probably has the best rotation in the NBA.
Second baseman, John Wegler.
So, bottom of the sixth, Wegler is leading off. The Hornets trail 2-0. That pitch way outside of ball one. Have to expect something in the strike zone here. And there's the strike. Counts 2-1. Hornets like to see a lot of pitches. You try to get a full count pretty much every time at bat. Counts now 2-2. Wegler has fouled that one back. Count still 2-2, 0 outs. Bottom of the sixth inning, Hornets trail by 2 runs.
Win the fight, kid. Win the fight, three.
That one is low and away for a ball three. Full count here, 3-2. Caught him looking for strike three.
Now batting for the Hornets, shortstop Trey Page.
Trey Page has been quiet today. One of the best freshmen in the NEAC, redshirt freshman. He is. Also a terrific left fielder. Hits a shot. Will it go over the fence? It doesn't, but it does go to the wall. For a stand-up double, that's exactly what the Hornets needed. And Trey Page has displayed all year long. He has
And batter for the Hornets, Cole Gehring.
Trey Page has some speed to him as well. Like that hit to that big gap that you can see in the middle of second and first. That's where Gehring was going, but popped it up instead of getting something more on the line. And one pitch out. That's uncommon for Cole Gehring.
That is the Hornets first baseman, Hugh Bolden.
Bolden, the runner on second, two outs. Big moment here for the Hornets. They're trying to get back into this game. Bolden has one hit in the game so far. First pitch is a ball.
Aggressive here. Here we go. On strike.
Count is 1-1, two outs. And Bolden get the Hornets on the board. Good eye there from Bolden. Count is now 2-1.
Good night.
Count is 3-1 for Bolden.
Hey, cut something here. Come on,
Forrest. Freshman from Middletown, Delaware. Majoring in accounting.
We're trying to drive here, kid. Come on.
And that one is a strike, so it's a full count, 3-2. Two outs. Big moment. Want to at least swing at something if it's within that strike zone, or if you think it's close to the strike zone, don't want to go down looking here. And hey, he forces a walk. Showing confidence in his eye. Doesn't get jammed up on that pitch that was inside and a little low.
Now batting for the Hornets, third baseman, Jared Gillis.
Jared Gillis, we mentioned how he's trying to turn to form. Best way to show that you're fully back is to get an RBI here. Runners on first and second. And probably shouldn't have swung at that one.
Hey, hunt strikes here, 3-1. Hunt strikes, kid.
That one was clearly out of the strike zone. You can hear some chatter from the dugout telling him to wait for his pitch. Something low and inside is not really what you're looking to swing at, especially on the first pitch of the at-bat. Gillis swings again and rounds out the third base. They play there. I'm gonna stay right here tonight, 'cause I could be dangerous. Looks like Corey Wolfer's day is done. Six innings of work. So in five hits, just one earned run and six strikeouts and two walks. Difficult situations, but for the most part, pitched his way out of it. Now, pair of names. Let's see if it's a pitch for the Hornets. A little bit of information on Davis's season so far. This is his eighth appearance. In his last seven, one game has two losses. He sports an ERA of 8.7. He's surrendered 16 hits, 13 earned runs. He has 11 strikeouts and also 11 hits. He has earned just one home run. 13 one earned innings of play.
Now pitching for the Hornets, number 8, Hiram Davis.
Davis
leading off the 7th for North Carolina Central. Center fielder Nick Pizarro.
Is a local.
Here we go, kid.
Grew up in Dover, Delaware. Played his high school baseball in Dover as well. Counts 1-1 after the low pitch there. Nick Fajardo, who has one hit and one strikeout, was caught looking last time. Fouls that one back. Counts 1-2. Top of the 7th once again. The Eagles are clinging on to a 2-run lead. They scored both of their runs in the 3rd inning. Outside of that, hasn't been too much success. They've gotten runners on, but has struck out when it mattered the most. Fajardo checking his swing. That could have been strike 3 regardless, but instead it's a full count here. And that went way off the mark. Ball 4. Coco Figueredo back up to bat. He has one hit, one run. He's also grounded out twice. Grounded out into a double play earlier in today's game. And the bunt works out in Eagles' favor. The Eagles had some difficulty, which removed the double play out of the equation. He's only able to go to first. And now you have a runner in second base in Nick Pizarro.
Now batting for the Eagles, catcher Chet Sykes.
Chet Sykes, who had that 2-run RBI. Back in the 3rd inning, things up to bat. He's been pretty good in the last few contests here in this series. Has proven to be a dangerous hitter in this Eagles lineup. And you can hear some chatter from the stands. That's a spot that he's been consistently calling a ball to. Strike number two. Count is 1-2.
Throw that, Byron.
That one high counts 2-2. Good job by Jahil blocking the pitch and making sure Fajardo can't advance to third base. Count is 4-3-2 with one out. Runner on second. And the liner past Weglars will have a play at the plate, but not much of a play. Fajardo reaches home base for the third run of the game. Sykes is at second. He's going to advance on the throw. And wanted to show the celebration on the Eagles dugout, but don't have an angle here on the camera.
Hey, we paid a lot of money for them.
Meeting at the mound here.
Where are you going?
Come on. Trying to give some instructions to his pitcher. Hiram Davis. Once again, their head coach, J.P. Blandon, was tossed earlier after an extensive argument and a play at first where Miguel Rivera was called out.
Hi, come on now.
A couple innings ago. Is low for ball one. One out. Hornets trail 3-0. In the top of the seventh. And that one is close to the edge of the plate as you can get. Called ball two. It's definitely a hitter's strike zone. The Eagles have taken advantage. The Hornets have not. A great effort, but Bolden can't make a play. He probably saved the run by at least getting a glove on the line drive.
Hey, roll you a pair here. Get at it.
He was going on to talk about how
roll a pair, get at it. We're all right.
He has been one of the best in the MEAC, especially last season before the lockdown. Runners on the corners, only one out. For Hiram Davis, you would love a double play to get yourself out of this situation. Let's see if the Hornets can execute. Instead, we'll get a fly ball, but it'll be a foul ball headed towards the bullpen area. Jerome Davis, once again, a freshman from Dover, Delaware, played his high school ball at Dover High School. Good pitch there, swing and miss. With strike number two. Count is 0-2. One out. Runners on the corners. And that one passed the outstretched arms of Jared Gillis. That will bring one run home. Hornets trail 4-0. And it's growing increasingly likely that this Eagles team will be able to split the series with two wins apiece. This is the second visit at the mound, so Jerome Davis will have to be subbed out. Rough outing there for Davis, surrendering a couple of runs. Davis just one third of an inning, with three hits for two earned runs. Also had walk the batter. And those are some of the growing pains that you have to go through. Solid. Some applause for him, but you know he's freshman. He expects better of himself, but he'll get another opportunity in the future. Ethan Edelson. He has an ERA of 6.23. 8.2 innings of work. He has 3 wins and 4 losses on his record. Strikeouts, but does have 13 walks in this 8.2 innings. Excuse me, he is 1-0 in those 7 games that he's played. 2-4. And he's out. Some struggles with his control. Wasn't really submitted to the hits, but it's a wild experience for him to be able to stop on the mound. But he won to be given close here. A 4-run deficit is already pretty hard to come back from, especially against Brian Miller, as we talked about how prolific he is as a pitcher. He might be trying to go for the pitcher to be gone.
Now pitching for Delaware State, number 10,
Keith Sonnenfeld.
That's for the Eagles, right fielder Jacob Raby.
Going against Jacob Raby. Raby is 0-3 with 2 strikeouts in today's game. After I mentioned how well he was doing, he hasn't gotten a hit since. Pretty nice fastball there. Let's that just has not been given. Counts 2-1. One out. Runners on first and second. Hornets trail by 4 runs. 2 runs of the 4 have been given up in this inning. That one low. Good job by Trujillo blocking it.
Keep working, Rob.
Counts 3-1. One out. Once again, Adelson has walked 13 batters in his 8 2/3 innings of work so far this season. That one in for a strike, full count. And this one is popped up to the bleachers again. Everybody just ducking for cover when that happens. This one is fouled to Regulars, trying to Rivera, but play can't be made. It actually was fouled to Regulars, who's moved back to second base. Trey Page has moved to shortstop. Looks like Rivera's day is done. That pitch is fouled away. Bases are loaded with one out. The only two things you can hope for the Hornets is a strikeout here or a double play. Aaron makes the play for out. But, excuse me, one run does advance home for the third run of the inning. Score is now 5-0. Aaron almost collided with Kimmel in the outfield. Runners on first and third. Maynard back up to the plate.
Come on, Ethan!
A collision at the plate there. Let's see what they'll roll here. Want to roll them safe.
The pro took him into the pad.
Trujillo doesn't agree with the call. Both players a little upset with each other. It was a pretty big collision. As it stands, runner scores. Double steal is successful. That's something the Hornets have fallen for in this series. Trujillo normally aggressive, trying to catch people stealing. in that situation with a man at third.
Hey, shake it off, Rob.
Not sure if that was the best decision. But true to his nature, he's an aggressive catcher. And he's not going to second guess back there. Score is now 6-0, a 4-run seventh inning. We've seen that a couple of times in the series where in the seventh inning, Hornets have really allowed a lot of runs. We saw that the first game of the doubleheader yesterday. As they're not getting as much support as you would like from the pitchers in the bullpen. But at that point, it wasn't really Edelson's fault. It's just great base running from the Eagles. Count is 0-2 with two outs. Hornets desperately need to get out of the jam without surrendering more runs. Counts 1-2. And Trujillo's still shaken up from that collision, and he might need to be subbed out. Might be bleeding from that collision. We're going to take a look at him. He tried to toughen it out, but it was a really hard collision with him and Luis De Leon. Still at the plate. And Mason Brewer is subbing in at catcher. And while we have a break, we'll talk about the football game that happened last night. Delaware State's bid for a successful end to this unique spring football season was marked by missed opportunities, resulting in a 31-28 overtime loss to South Carolina State. Rob Trujillo is back on his feet, continuing with the football story. Hornets lost 31-28. In overtime to South Carolina State at Alumni Stadium last night. Dyson Robertson kicked a 23-yard field goal in the first overtime session to give SC State the victory in a two-game sweep of the Hornets this spring. Delaware State had the ball first in overtime but failed to score when quarterback Jarrett Lewis lost a fumble on a sack at the SC State 15-yard line. The Hornets missed a golden opportunity to win the game in regulation. The score was 28-28 when Delaware State linebacker Kamari Jackson intercepted a pass at the Bulldogs' 33-yard line with 1:59 left in the fourth quarter. Four plays later after the pick, DSU's kicker Jose Romero Martinez missed wide right on a 36-yard field goal attempt as time expired. The Hornets fall to 2-3 on the season. They will be idle until the fall season resumes next year. Oh, 2 with two outs in an inning that has gone awry for the Hornets. They have surrendered 4 in the top of the 7th. Count is 3-2 with two outs. Ellison, who has that strikeout ability, let's see if he can get Maynard swinging and missing here. And no, that one is off the mark. The runner will advance to third without much of a challenge from Brewer. And then we've talked about Ellison. He has the ability to strike people out, but he also has some control issues. Wild pitch there allows a runner to advance to third, so we have runners on the corners after that. All 4. Justin Bowers has been impressive this series. He's up to bat. Once again, the Hornets trail 6-0 in the top of the 7th inning. And here, a really good job by Weglars. Weglars is able to catch a man stealing, going for second. His court mater got caught in that situation.
Hey! Whoa! Hey!
But instead of throwing it, shortstop at second, yeah. So switch up to
the
double steal opportunity to spot the
hammer. It's kind of like giving you fame away. It's more with you. I sit in a box where the owners do. A boss is running, I've grown into. I love it, but I told you the truth. I can't see you with my
heart. Yeah, I got
one Virgil, got one in that game. It's the only 2, man. How many times have I shown it? Cool, man. How many times have I been swerving the pot balls? That's a hundred wheels on the road.
Once again, I'm broadcasting and I'm also filming and looking at you with the shot I just did while speaking to you guys at the same time. It's a very rare story that I
just
wish I would know
how to do this all the time. Okay, we'll see what's about to happen next. Okay, we'll see what's about to happen.
And back to action. As Mason Brewer, who had to sub in for Robert Trujillo,
is catching Mason Brewer.
Is up to bat. Not the hitter that Trujillo is, batting under 200. But he does have some power to him. When he does make some contact, he can go yard. The first game of this series, he had a solo shot to center field. That was in the Friday contest. And he just missed that one. Actually, it drops in. Looked like it was going to be a fly out to left field, but instead it drops in between left fielder and the shortstop.
Offense for Delaware State right fielder Trip Kimmel.
After wonder of Lewis, game long, you see that collision with Trujillo, just isn't feeling right because he just didn't have a good jump on the ball and allow it to fall in for a single.
Oh yeah, that's the baseball.
The bunt is going to be ruled foul. Kimmel trying anything to get on base because he knows if he doesn't, that we will have some words with him because he promised us a hit. Almost got that bunt down, but almost doesn't cut it. We work here in the athletic department with us. We want results.
Thank you.
This would be a strikeout for Trip Kimmel. Mark Harris returns to the plate as we're at the bottom of the order.
Batting for the Hornets, center fielder is Mark Harris.
Mark Heron with two strikeouts and a flyout in his previous three at bats. And he fouls that one up of play. Counts 0-2, one out, runner on first base. When it's trail, 6-0 to the bottom of the seventh. Heron, did he hit himself into a double play? He doesn't. It's a good slide by Brewer, who reaches base for the second time on the fielder's choice.
Batting for the Hornets, left fielder Mike Worthington.
I believe he subbed in for Miguel Rivera, whose day has come to an end. He was allowing some frustration to boil over, and probably for the best sat him down for the rest of the game. Counts 1-0 with two outs, runner on first base. Made solid contact, but it will be out. Number three. Good play by Figueredo at second base. Hornets trail 6-0 as we head to the top of the game. Adelson up and down is first inning of relief. Main out for the mound. That's a running a sack fly for a run. Also had a walk and a wild pitch. But was able to get those two outs. There's a fly out. For a third out.
I made a killing, I rock on the game. My content repeated, my silence. I'm in the hate and they made me a beast. He was a lady on top of the ground. The two tomatoes, he causes me to call. He was. Leading off the eighth for North Carolina Central, first baseman Justin Ballard.
From Jared Gillis for the out number one of the top of the eighth inning. It was Bowers who grounded out to third base.
Now batting for the Eagles, center fielder Nick Fajardo.
Nick Fajardo scored last time he was up at bat. First pitch was a strike. Count 0-1. One out. Fajardo trying to lay down a bunt. Can he beat out the throw? The throw is wide. Thought about taking two, and sorry, I forgot to move the camera. Guys missed all the action on that one. But, you know, doing two jobs at once. Sometimes you're unable to do both at the same time. Won't make any excuses. Happens though. Runner on first. Throw is wide. Edelson didn't really have a great angle to make the throw without hitting Fajardo, so he had to loft it over his head. There's a wild pitch, and Fajardo will steal a base there easily. And we talk about Edelson's control issues. He doesn't surrender a lot of hits, but that's because he surrenders a ton of walks. He does have a really good fastball when he can locate it right. He can be really aggressive with it, but sometimes he's trying to throw too hard. You'll see wild pitches like we did there. Even though that fastball wasn't the hardest throw ball, just didn't have great control. But comes right back with a nice pitch on the right corner of the plate for strike one. Counts 1-1 with one out, runner on second. One is trailed 6-0 on the top of the eighth. Eagles trying to extend their lead, as this game is very similar to the game we saw yesterday in the first game of the doubleheader when the Eagles run one, 9-3. They did it by scoring a ton of runs in the seventh inning. And they've done this exact same thing here in the final game of our four-game series here on DESU-TV live stream. Counts 2-2. With one out.
You got 10.
And the ground ball to the Jaguars for out number two. Runner doesn't advance to third. And you see a little bit of a discussion there at third base. Chet Sykes, who has two RBIs in today's game, at bat with a chance to add some more points for the Eagles. There is two out from the top of the eight. Counts 2-0. Excuse me, it's 3-0 with two outs. Counts now 3-1. Still with the runner on third base. Kettleson had to come in relief for Harum Davis, who unfortunately struggled at the mound after he came in relief for CJ Loper. A hard hit ball, but it's caught by Mark Harum for out number three. He's been solid back there at center field for the Hornets today. Somebody on base, and he turns into an even better pitcher.
John Wedlar.
Wedlar's up to bat. If they want to start a rally, he's the guy who can normally spark that. At first pitch is a foul for strike number one. Bottom of the eighth inning, Hornets trail 6-0. Thank you for tuning in to the DESU-TV live stream. My name is Derek Slayton. I am broadcasting and also doing the camera work in today's game. I'm a utility player. They put me wherever, and I still do what's needed for the group.
Thank you.
game court Maynard. Did a good job hustling down there and getting out number one. In the bottom of the eighth inning.
Now batting for the Hornets, Trey Page.
Another terrific hitter in this corner's lineup. And nobody's really been terrific against Ryan Miller in today's contest. First pitch is the ball. One out after the Weglar's pop up was handled by Maynard. And this one will be grounded to second base. Figueroa makes easy work of that one for out number two. So opportunities are running out for the Hornets.
Just been outclassed so far.
Ryan Miller has really dominated from the mound today. Gary got a lot of that one, but it falls harmlessly foul. Counts 3-2 with two outs in the bottom of the eighth inning. On his trail by 6 runs, Cole Gary will take a little bit of a timeout as you can see Chandler Fitzgerald running to go get the foul ball, making sure he doesn't get hit. Discipline at the plate, he forces a walk.
Now batting for the Hornets, first baseman, Coop Holder.
2 outs, runner on first base. Coop Holder. First ball, well, first pitch is a ball for Miller. Going up against Cool Bolden again. Bolden grounds it to third. They'll go to second instead for out number three. The score remains 6-0. As we head to the top of the ninth.
Alright. Always
not my best. Got to keep the there on camera.
The girl of your dreams.
We got there together as a team. Two more insurance runs, even though Ryan Miller, the way he is pitching, he probably doesn't need it. First pitch is a ball for Edelson. And a line drive to center field for the first hit of this inning. Tristan Shea on first base after that. Jordan Valeria Payne is now at bat. First pitch is a strike. This is Payne's first appearance in today's game. Brought in more for defense on the other side. As Central Eagles are just three outs away from winning once they reach the bottom of the ninth. Count is 1-1. Now it's 2-1. And what was once a lively atmosphere, you can see it's dead quiet after that 4-run, 7th inning by the Eagles. Really took the air out of the building. And a wild pitch. Tristan Shea advances to second. No outs here in the top of the ninth. The count is 3-1. And able to get Payne to fly out to Trip Kimmel in right field. He's been solid back there in right field. But he still might have to hear a Barney song next game at home. Unless he gets a hit pretty quickly in the bottom of the ninth inning. But we're not there yet, still at the top of the ninth. One out. Runner on second base. counts 1-1 after that strike. Counts 2-1, one out, top of the ninth inning. That pitch is low. Nice job by Rady. Finding a gap in the right field. Runners on the corners with one out. And Cameron Norgren. In his two at bats, has struck out and has been hit by a pitch. Looking to get an RBI here and extend the lead for the Eagles. A foul ball. Still one out and runners on the corners for the Eagles. Norgren gets jammed up just a tad bit and another foul for him. Counts 1-2. Let's see if Ellison can, excuse me, get a strikeout here. And fly out. We'll get a throw at the plate. Will we get a play? And we do. Great throw. Great play from Mason Brewer for out number 3.
Should I never let you know it's put you back in with the water
bag? Mike Morgan's able to catch out of left field and threw a ball right on the line. Mason Brewer, whole wide attack for the third out.
She like the way that I dance. She like the way that I move. She like the way that I rock. She like the way that I move. She let it clap on.
She let it clap on.
And she do it back on.
And she do it back on.
Like a man, like a man. Then it's same as a team. Christian Dior, the door. Just come up in all the stores. When it rains, it pours. She like the way I like a man, like a man. Billy Jean, Billy Jean, Christian Dior, the door. Come up in all the stores. When it rains, it pours. She like the way I love these back. 30 on me, buy the cup, store it on pay. Come on, get me lit. I can't put this game. All in my page, fucking. All of my comments are screaming my name while I'm in the club, doing them hundreds and fifties and bars. I smoke, they know I'm loving. If I'm on the island, I'm smashing his tail. When he got locked, the night is real. Until he's free, I'm ready to hell. So my shoes cool. All the times that I was paid up, looking like I was staked up. If you need to get you can take money. Ain't nobody open up. You know I'm like that. I make a movie like James T. Rap 30 for me, ask who really want it. I bet I ain't real like DSU. I keep you wanted in my section, and I keep that 38 for the weapon. Remember when I came home, a correction. All the bad, so my direction. She like the way that I dance. She like the way that I move. She like the way that I rock. She like the way that I woo. And she let it clap for it. They keep doing back for it.
Jerry Gillis here in the bottom of the ninth inning. Woods have a lot of work to do.
Baseman Jared Gillis.
Down 6-0. And Caleb McRoy is in for Ryan Miller. Miller had a terrific outing in his 8 innings, only surrendered 6 hits. Didn't give up any runs. He had 6 strikeouts and just 3 walks in the 32 batters that he faced. Caleb McRoy is a lefty, 6'2", 190, red shirt sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina.
Hey, let's go, Gil! Oh, yeah!
McRoy has a record of 1-3 in 10 appearances. Has 1 save on a season. ERA of 5.3. In 18 2/3 innings of work, he has surrendered 11 hits for 11 earned runs. He struck out 25 and walked 19 of the 85 batters he's faced so far in the season. Good swing there for Gillis, just couldn't connect all the way and fouls it. Full count here, 3-2, 0 outs, bottom of the ninth. Hornets trail 6-0. And a 4-run inning by the Eagles in the seventh has really made this difficult game to come back from. And Gillis goes down swinging for out number one. Mason Brewer, who had this up there for Robert Trujillo, who took a pretty tough collision a couple innings ago at the plate.
Catcher Mason Brewer.
As Luis De Leon slid right into him. It's both players collided and was down for a while. Trujillo and De Leon both walked up, got up and walked under their own power. So it doesn't seem like the situation was too serious. Both players did leave the game. One ball, one strike, one out. Bottom of the ninth inning. Drop in, no, it will not.
My life be like,
good play by Figueroa.
My life be like,
showing his range. He's
got that second base, right?
Able to get to the shallow right field for that catch.
My life be like,
and Kimmel as well. He's in the game for at least one more at bat. He's been terrific in the outfield, as we've mentioned. But can he do good at the plate here for them? I believe he drew a walk in his last at bat.
What's he been?
that one kind of curved in on him, a good pitch there. So 0-2, two outs, bottom of the ninth. That one is low and away. Good job by Phil staying away and not swinging. Count is 1-2 and two outs. Phil checks his swing and he doesn't go. Counts 2-2. That ball was outside. Good job by Kimmel. Count is 2-2. Once again, two outs. Bottom of the ninth inning. At one, ball three, a little outside. That's a call that's been consistent on both ends. And a swing and a miss, and that will be the game. The Hornets will fall 6-0, and they will be unable to win the series. Instead, it is tied up at 2-2. The Hornets fall to 9-6 in the MEAC. Thank you for tuning in to the DESU live stream. The next game we will be covering is at 10 a.m. on April 24th, which is next Saturday. We have a lacrosse match as the Hornets take on Furman University at 10 a.m. at Alumni Stadium. And then at 12 p.m., we have baseball coverage as the Hornets take on their rival in Norfolk State. That game starts at 12. Softball also Norfolk State in a doubleheader. That starts at 1, and then the second period is at 3. And the Hornets will wrap up their doubleheader in baseball at 3 p.m. as well against Norfolk State. Once again, this is Derek Slayton signing off for DESU-TV. Hopefully, we will be able to see you all soon on Saturday. Thank you, and have a good rest of the afternoon and evening.